Hi, I'm Rhonda Hastings, and I want to welcome you to this Daily Word of Encouragement. I love that title, don't you? I think that sometimes we all need just a little bit of an encouragement now and then, and it really is a joy to be able to be here with you, to just share with you what God's placed on my heart. A week or so ago, I had to go for some medical tests, and to be quite honest with you, they hurt. I mean, really. I'm trying to take care of my health, but in order to do that, I had to take tests that cause pain. Somehow that just seems to be contradictory. I began thinking about how often that really does happen. I mean, sometimes we have to have blood drawn, and those needles look pretty intimidating, and sometimes we have to have uncomfortable x-rays. I really hate it when the doctor pushes on that very spot that's hurting. And oftentimes, the same kind of things happen spiritually. There are times that pain is required in order for us to be able to find the true healing that we need. In 2 Corinthians 1, verses 8 through 11, Paul talks about a time in his life when he experienced something like this. He said that he suffered intense affliction while he was trying to minister in Asia. He said it was so intense that it was beyond his strength to endure. It was so bad, he didn't even think he was going to live through it. That sounds pretty bad to me. And if that had been me, I know myself, I would have been wondering why God would allow me to go through something so painful when all I was trying to do was minister to others and expand his kingdom. Somehow that just doesn't seem fair. You know what I mean? But the Bible teaches us that God is able to bring amazing results from our suffering. In fact, I want to give you an assurance. I want to give you a guarantee. God never, ever, ever wastes pain. Did you hear that? God never wastes pain. If he allows you to suffer, then there's a really good reason for that. In this case, Paul says God allowed his suffering so that he could learn a really important lesson. God wanted Paul to learn to trust in the Lord completely and not in his own self. In my mind, that's a really good reason. You see, God was going to use Paul's life to plant the seeds that would change a world. Paul was going to face some really hard things. And he needed to know beyond a shadow of a doubt that he could completely trust God. He had to know that the miraculous power of God is able to make a way out of no way. It is able to breathe life into death. It is able to transform suffering into life and able to comfort in the midst of despair. Paul had to learn that he could not trust what he could see or hear or plan for himself. I can assure you with absolute confidence that your pain has a purpose. I can't tell you what that purpose is, but I know that God will use it to prepare you and to position you for the great things that he has in store for you. There was another truth that Paul shares in 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verses 10 through 11, which says, "He has delivered us from such a deadly peril, and he will deliver us again. On him, we have set our hope that he will continue to deliver us as you help us by your prayers." Do you see that? We need to pray not only for ourselves, but for each other, because our prayers are powerful. And when life is hurting, we help one another as we intercede in prayer for each other. I want to thank you right now for the times that you've prayed for me. Those prayers were heard by God, and he moved in my circumstances, and he helped me through the pain and the difficulties. Thank you. I hope this word really did encourage you today. Be strong in the Lord, my friend. He is truly able to help. And in the meantime, we are praying for you. God bless you. Have a beautiful, wonderful day. Bye-bye.